What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. If you think about it, there are two ways to describe what an application is meant to do. You can focus on the features or the requirements of your app, where you say the system must do this or the application must achieve that. Or you can focus on the users of your application by answering how does a certain user accomplish a particular goal with our application. Describing your application in a user-focused manner and contrary to the feature-focused manner allows you to write these requirements in everyday language, as non-technical as possible. A typical user of this app should be able to read one of these descriptions and understand it. Now, there is no one required way to write these, but there are two formats commonly used in this phase of the design process. One is called a use case, and the other is a user story. In this video, we're going to talk about both, and in a later video, we are going to expand on how we can design or draw these use cases. So, the most essential parts of a use case are the title that describes the goal we are looking for, the person or actor who wants that goal satisfied, and the scenario or series of steps needed to accomplish the goal. These steps describe a complete encounter between the actor and our system, hence can have multiple possible results, and can even include sections for when things go wrong. Now, the best title for a use case is a short phrase with an active verb. Examples here might be add a new member, send mail, purchase items in cart, create note, and so on. These could all be separate use cases which define distinct goals of our application. Then we have the actor. The reason that we say actor rather than just user is because we often need to identify exactly who is having this interaction. It could be a generic user, but also a customer, member, or administrator, and it even doesn't have to be a human being. It could be another computer system or service interacting with our application. So any external entity that acts on our system is an actor. Now comes the scenario, or the details that will help us achieve this one goal. This could be written as a single paragraph, like the one you see in front of you. This paragraph should be short and easy to understand by any typical user of the application. It's also very common to write the scenario as individual steps, as a numbered list. Now, notice that in both examples we wrote, we described the normal expected flow, or what we call the success scenario. Again, this is not pseudocode. This is not something we take to our code editor and start writing. We are not there yet, and we're not trying to be. Now, depending on the situation, you can add extensions to your success scenario, steps for alternative flows, like what happens when items are out of stock, or for when things go wrong, like payment problems. And if it's more useful, you can add more specific details about the scenario. One common example would be a precondition. What must be true to begin this use case? Here, perhaps the precondition would be a customer has added at least one item to the shopping cart. That's the only way this use case makes sense. Okay, after writing the title, actor, scenario, and possibly a precondition for your use case, you should be fine and ready to go. And 95% of the time, you won't be required to write more than that. However, you may sometimes encounter fully dressed use cases, and these go beyond the usual fields we just discussed to include multiple placeholders for a trigger and description, preconditions, postconditions, stakeholders, etc. And these often exist as PDF templates or Word document templates that you can fill in. Now, as I mentioned earlier, there are also use case diagrams. But forget about the diagram for a moment, because use cases are first and foremost written texts and not diagrams. We will see the use case diagrams in a future video. But as with all diagrams, they are here to support written use cases and not replace them. Let's go ahead now and expand on actors and scenarios. An actor in a use case is anything with behavior who lives outside of our system, outside of our application, but has a goal they want to accomplish within. And these are usually human beings, but not always. Sometimes coming up with the actor is very straightforward, like if you are building a simple one-person application. And sometimes you might need to spend a few minutes brainstorming the main actors of your app or a particular use case. What you can start by doing is separate human and non-human interactions between your app and the outside world. You see, it's quite common that use cases involve multiple actors, and we'll typically refer to them as the primary actors and the secondary or supporting actors. Now, the primary actors aren't necessarily the most important actors in the scenario. They're just the one who initiated this particular use case. So in the example we previously wrote, the primary actor was the customer. Anyone else is a secondary actor. Now, the initiated use case might go through a lot of steps, and some of these steps might fail, and that leads us into talking more about sketching out these steps in the scenario part of our use case. When we describe a use case scenario, we're typically looking at describing a goal that an actor can accomplish in a single encounter, and we're trying to stay focused on the user's goal, on their intention. So, for example, log into application might first sound like a use case. It has an active verb, it typically has multiple steps, multiple conditions, you could forget the password or be required to register, and so on. But if we emphasize on the user's goal, we realize that their goal with our system is not to log in. The reason they want to log in is to do something. So what is that something in your system? Is it to purchase items? To check their account balance? These are user-focused goals, each with several steps that could be accomplished in one encounter. Logging in might be part of these use cases, part of one of these goals, but it's not a use case on its own. When writing a scenario, you want to focus on the true goal of the user, emphasize on one of the encounters. Now, a simple casual use case can still have multiple scenarios. We've talked about the main success scenario, that's the one you want to focus on. But when necessary, you also need to describe the alternate path or extensions. So, in the case of purchasing items, you might have a couple of options for what happens when something is out of stock. What happens if the customer payment method is rejected? However, here you're not trying to lay out all the possible events, just the typical situations that would occur and what would you want to do with those situations. When you're writing, use active voice. Omit needless words, omit needless details. It's very common to see sentences like, "The system is provided with the payments information by the customer." But you could just as easily say, "Customer provides payment information." Active voice, easier to read, short, concise. Notice also that we're describing all this without the words like page, click, button, select, mouse, none of that. There's no click the checkout button. We're focusing on the intention. The user interface will follow the function of our application and what we want to do. Now, once you come up with your first actors and goals, you should ask yourself a few more questions to see if you've missed anything. Like, do we have role-based actors? And if so, who is the administrator of our system? Or who manages the users of our system? What happens if the system fails? Is anyone monitoring our system's activity or storing logs? You will often find that these questions will reveal a couple obvious actors for your application. Finally, before ending the video, I want to briefly mention user stories. A user story is simpler and shorter than a use case. It still describes a single small scenario from a user's perspective, focused on their goal rather than on the system, but unlike a use case, which could be extended, as we discussed, to several pages, a user story is typically written as just one, perhaps two sentences. This forces us to keep them very short, and that's kind of the point here. User stories follow a particular format, and the format looks something like this. As a user or role, I want a particular goal so that I benefit from it in this particular way. An example could be that, as a user, I want to be able to sort the entries by date so that I can find the most recent content. Focused on one specific goal of one specific user for a particular reason or benefit. User stories focus on intent. What we're doing is expressing one need. We're not detailing alternate paths or exceptions or listing any technical information. They're a very quick, readable summary of what a specific goal is and why the user wants it. When you first hear about them, it can be tempting to regard a user story as just a shorter use case, but that would be a mistake. They are really very different things. A user story is a placeholder for a conversation. It's a reminder that we need to get deeper into the details of something, whereas a use case can be regarded as a record of a conversation that already happened. It will detail the steps of how a particular goal may or may not be achieved. Use cases are regarded as the more formal, unified process methodology you'd use. But if you're working in a Scrum environment, which we will discuss in future videos, you should expect to see a focus on user stories. Anyway, however you do it, I assure you that describing your system in simple language and easy-to-read terms is incredibly useful. So, That's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.